announcement in compliance with the Open Public Meetings Act, Chapter 231, Public Law 1975, Laws of the State of New Jersey. The Borough Clerk has prepared a schedule of the meetings of the governing body of the Borough of Kenilworth for the year 2020. The Borough Clerk has posted a true copy of this schedule on the bulletin board located at the front entrance of Borough Hall and has mailed true copies of this schedule to the local source, the Star Ledger, and the Home News Tribune, and is maintaining a copy of this schedule in her office during the year 2020. Accordingly, the notice requirements of the Open Public Meeting Act have been satisfied in regard to this meeting. Please stand for the salute to the flag. Roll call, Madam Clerk.
Councilwoman Cesari?
Here.
Councilman Clemente?
Here.
Councilman David?
Here.
Councilman Agati?
Here.
Councilman Lopez?
Here.
Councilman Shelkey?
Here.
All are present.
Can I have a motion to accept minutes of the work executive session and regular council meetings of January 22nd, 2020?
Motion.
Second.
Motion made by Councilwoman Cesari, seconded by Councilman Clemente. All in favor?
Aye.
I abstained.
How is that?
Various advisories were received from the New Jersey State League of Municipalities. And the County of Union sent an invitation for the point in time count and survey, as well as notification of the 2020 infrastructure grant opportunity. The Historical Society is requesting permission for the townwide yard sale for October 10th and 11th. Comcast and Verizon submitted the annual municipal right-of-way payment. NJEC is requesting the borough adopt an ordinance banning plastic bags. Monarch notified the borough that they will be permanently closing their EMS services facility. And Somerset Union Soil Conservation District announced the availability of new services. And we also received the department reports for January for the clerk's office, court, finance, fire department, police department, public works, planning, and zoning.
Okay, thank you. Is there a motion to accept communications and reports?
So moved.
Second.
Motion made by Councilman Mugatti, seconded by Councilman Cesari. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Valentine's Day is quickly approaching and love will soon be in the air. I would like to wish everyone a happy Valentine's Day. If you are looking for ways to woo your Valentine, we have plenty of fine restaurants to choose from in town for a romantic dinner. Please remember to support our local small businesses for flowers and gift for your loved one. I'm confident you will find the perfect gift locally right here in town. And on behalf of the borough, Councilman Clemente and myself recently attended the Railway River Watershed Flood Control Meeting. I would like to praise Councilman Clemente on his participation and our representation at the table for Kenilworth. New flood mitigation plans were discussed along with working with county, state, and federal officials to pursue funds and work towards solutions that all stakeholders can agree on. And with that, I would like to move on to the finance report. Councilman Lopez.
Thank you, Mayor. This first quarter tax collection period has ended. Tax and finance office experienced considerable amount of activity. 772 people visited the tax office and paid their taxes in person from January 21st through February 11th. 223 mailed tax payments were processed from January 27th, 2020 through February 11th, 2020. 165 payments were received electronically. 19 payments were made through a 24-hour, 7 days a week lockbox service. The 2020 budget process continues. The committee has met with the police, public works, board of health, and we are looking forward to meeting with the library, buildings and grounds, engineering within the next 2 weeks. I also submitted a statement on proposed American water price increase by 12%. It's a substantial amount, I believe, and I will be attending the public hearing to obtain more information. Thank you, Mayor.
Okay, thank you. Department of Public Works, Councilman David.
Thank you, Mayor. A couple things. Recycling will be picked up on February 17th along with garbage, even though it's a holiday. So February 17th, recycling and garbage pickups will still be taking place. Mixed vegetation is still being collected every Wednesday, leaf, branches, grass, has to be in 32-gallon container or brown leaf bags. And that's all I got.
Okay, thank you, Councilman David. Department of Public Safety, Councilman Clemente.
Thank you, Mayor. I'm in receipt of the Kenilworth Municipal Court monthly report for January 2020. I'm also in receipt of the January monthly police report for January 2020. And I have a report tonight from our Chief Zimmerman. There were 2,114 calls for service, 183 911 calls, and 186 motor vehicle summons issued for the month of January 2020. So there was a lot of activity. On January 27th, the Detective Bureau interviews were held, and Officer Sean Caverick was chosen to fill the open Detective Bureau assignment effective February 1st. Congratulations to Officer Caverick. And also a reminder about Swift 911. It's our emergency notification service provider. And you can go to the Borough website and sign up for it, or you can delete your name from it if you like, but it is there for everybody to go and check it out. And we do have a police officer opening. The Kenilworth Police Department is still accepting applications for the position of a police officer. The applicants must possess a valid New Jersey Police Training Commission certificate from the state of New Jersey as a certified police officer. Applications are available online at www.kenilworthborough.com and at the Kenilworth Police Department. Completed applications, resume, and a police training certificate must be returned to the Kenilworth Police Department in person by 4 p.m. on Friday, February the 14th, 2020. And that's all I have, Mayor.
Okay, thank you. Planning and Zoning, Councilman Shelkey.
Thank you, Mayor. I received both reports from the Zoning Officer and the Construction Department. They were in order. The Planning Board meets tomorrow. They have one case on the agenda. Last meeting in our workshop, the resident brought up some grading issues down by Flexivan, and the engineer's looking into that, and we'll have a further report next meeting. Thank you.
Thank you. Recreation and Fire, Councilwoman Cicere.
Thank you, Mayor. I received Chief Kruger's report for the month of January. He's currently on vacation, and John Morrow is acting chief until 2:15. That's February 15th. The report we had for the fire department responded to 48 calls. The rescue squad, 71 calls, for a total of 119 calls. And just one thing, the fire hydrants, the water company painted them. They look really nice. If there should be a snowstorm, I know we haven't had any snow, but if, you know, residents would just do their part maybe and just dig them out if they could, you know, if they're on their property, it would help out the fire department a lot. That's all I have for fire. Recreation, just a couple of announcements. The flyers will be handed out for upcoming events. Summer camp, softball, and crafts, which the dates are to be determined. And on Friday, February 14th, 7 p.m., will be the Valentine's Day dance at Harding Gym for grades 4, 5, and 6. And that's all I have. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. Health, Education, and Human Services, Councilman Labatty.
Thank you, Mayor. I'd like to first start off with the Kenilworth School District. They're still doing budget. They're still doing negotiations. And the one problem I see is that they're looking to expand the school, not this year, but maybe next year. So they're looking into that. Even though the population this year has declined, they're anticipating more students. So that would be good for our district. I don't know how they're going to get the money, but we'll see. The library, we have children's programs. I'd like to just go through them. We have LAPSIT for 0 to 2 years old, where they sit with their mom and dad or whatever and hear stories. We have toddler time, same thing. We have PJ story time. We have Lego in the library, which the kids love. And we have bingo for young children. That's the special events. Susical Junior. It's a group of players that come in and do plays for us, musicals, and introduce our young kids into the musical scenario. What else they're having is the Dental Health Magic Show, which is good for the kids. They're going to be there. They'll be tested. The adults, we still have the Arnie's, and we have the library book discussion group, I think, which is good. Next, we're going to go with the senior citizens. We've had access to working with the club and the senior citizens, and in the 1 month we had the locks changed on the building. We had the passwords for the video changed and updated, so we're in good shape there. Emails had a problem. We had those passwords changed. And again, thanks to Laura, who helped me out a lot. The HVAC, which was having a problem, and our dear mayor had her husband help us out, which is tremendous. And we have two buses of senior citizens now that are in operation. One bus is the older bus that was completely rehauled by the Department of Public Works. So kudos to them. Next we have the Board of Health. The Finance Committee met with the Board of Health and we went over their budget, and they're pretty self-sufficient with the health department. They'll have a rabies clinic. I think they asked for a little more money for the rabies clinic in the budget, but otherwise the next big event is the health fair in September. That's about all I have, Mayor.
Okay, thank you, Councilman Ledet.
Resolutions 1 through 15 are listed on the consent agenda and will be enacted by one motion. All items will be reported individually in full in the minutes. The consent agenda was introduced by Councilman Ledotti and seconded by Councilman Lopez. Councilman Cesari?
Yes.
Councilman Clemente?
Yes.
Councilman David?
Yes.
Councilman Ledotti?
Yes.
Councilman Lopez?
Yes.
And Councilman Shelkey?
Yes.
I have two ordinances this evening for an introduction. The first one is 2020-01, an ordinance of the Borough of Kenilworth amending the existing Chapter 120 Land Use Part 5 Affordable Housing Article 35 Development Fees within the Borough of Kenilworth, County of Union, State of New Jersey.
Okay, the purpose of this ordinance is to amend Chapter 120 Land Use Ordinance, whereby the Borough Council seeks to amend the non-residential development district fee within the borough to comply with state statute.
Resolution number 16 was introduced by Councilman Shelkey and seconded by Councilman David. Be it hereby resolved that ordinance number 2020-01, entitled an ordinance establishing policies and procedures for, an ordinance of the Borough of Kenilworth amending the existing Chapter 120 Land Use Part 5 Affordable Housing Article 35 Development Fees within the Borough of Kenilworth, heretofore introduced, is now passed on first reading, and that said ordinance be further considered for final passage at a meeting to be held on. March 11th at Borough Hall, and that at such time and place all persons interested be given an opportunity to be heard concerning said ordinance, and that the borough clerk is hereby authorized and directed to publish said ordinance in accordance with law. Councilman Cesari?
Yes.
Councilman Clemente?
Yes.
Councilman David?
Yes.
Councilman Ledotti?
Yes.
Councilman Lopez?
Yes.
And Councilman Shelkey?
Yes.
The next ordinance I have for introduction is 2020-02, an ordinance adding Chapter 181B, Towing, Police Requested, within the Borough of Kenilworth, County of Union, State of New Jersey.
Okay, the purpose of this chapter is to provide standards, regulations, and rates for police-requested towing and storage services requiring a response thereto by the licensee. It is the further purpose of this chapter to regulate these services from both a public safety perspective that would result in the quickest response time in good and bad weather, thereby minimizing waiting time both for police officers on scene and the removal of motor vehicles from the roadway as a result of an accident.
Resolution number 17 was introduced by Councilman Clemente and seconded by Councilman David. Be it hereby resolved that ordinance 2020-02, an ordinance adding Chapter 181B, Towing, Police Requested, within the Borough of Kenilworth, County of Union, State of New Jersey, heretofore introduced, is now passed on first reading, and that said ordinance be further considered for final passage at a meeting to be held on March 11, 2020, at 8 p.m. or as soon as thereafter as the matter can be reached at the regular meeting place of the Borough Council, and that at such time and place all persons interested be given an opportunity to be heard concerning said ordinance, and that the Borough Clerk is hereby authorized and directed to publish said ordinance in accordance with law. Councilman Cesari?
Yes.
Councilman Clemente?
Yes.
Councilman David?
Yes.
Councilman Ladati?
Yes.
Councilman Lopez?
Yes.
And Councilman Shumpy?
Yes.
Okay, I have. Thank you. We have a big birthday coming in the borough, March 3rd, the 100th birthday of Eugene Coppola. And I have a proclamation for him. Whereas the borough of Kenilworth respects and recognizes that longevity of life is a blessing for an individual and for a community, which benefits from the knowledge, creativity, and experiences this individual brings to all. And Eugene Victor Coppola, born at home on March 3rd, 1920, one of seven children born to Amando, George, and Rosa Coppola, who immigrated from Italy and settled in Kenilworth in 1911. Eugene Victor Coppola was a member of the 1938 first graduating class of Jonathan Dayton Regional High School in Springfield. As a boy, he worked in his father's vegetable store as a delivery boy. He also took up work at the Kensington Riding Academy and Newville's Riding Academy in Kenilworth, tasked with jobs such as grooming, training, and assisting riders. Mr. Coppola worked in various different factories in Kenilworth, including serving as the superintendent at the Volco Brass and Copper Company. However, he was renowned for his Jeans lunch truck, which served the factory workers of Kenilworth for three decades. And Eugene Victor Coppola, like many of his countrymen at the time, decided to serve in the United States of America in World War II as a private in the United States Army. While in the Army, he was deployed to Panama as well as various locations in the Pacific. He was joined by his brothers, Vincent and George, also known as Chickie, who also served in the Army. And his service to the country and community continued with the Volunteer Fire Department. Founding members of the Kenilworth Volunteer Ambulance and Rescue Squad, members of the VFW Post 2230, president of the Homeowners Mutual Benefit and Civic Association, and the Kenilworth Planning Board. And Eugene Victor Coppola and Evelyn Lee Dodd are now celebrating 76 years of marriage. Their union blessed them with a daughter, Evelyn Lee Coppola, who is married to Gary Delatouche. Mr. Coppola and his wife have three grandchildren and four great-grandchildren. Now, therefore, by virtue of the authority vested in me as the mayor of the Borough of Kenilworth, New Jersey, on behalf of the Borough Council, I do hereby proclaim March 3rd, 2020, as Eugene Victor Coppola Day in the Borough of Kenilworth. And on behalf of the Borough Council and the citizens of Kenilworth, I offer sincere congratulations and best wishes to Mr. Coppola for many more happy days in the future to share with friends and family. I hereby unto set my hand this 12th day on February 2020. Okay, I'd like this time a motion to open the floor to the public.
So moved.
Second.
Motion made by Councilman Lombardi, seconded by Councilman Cesari. All in favor?
Aye.
Does anyone have anything to say for the good and welfare of Kenilworth? Please come forward.
Yes, hi. Welcome, Mayor Karlovich.
Thank you.
And Councilman Lopez.
Thank you.
This past weekend, around 8:30 at night, two gentlemen came to our door, and I opened up the door and I spoke to them, and they wanted to help me with my relationship with Christ, and you know I told them, you know my relationship with God is fine and all, and I tried to hurry them along. The odd thing was that one of them had a lanyard, and I don't know what it said, I didn't read it, but if they were supposed to be coming around telling people, you know, about God or anything, why do it at dark, at 8:30 at night? You know, when Jehovah's Witness come around, they come around in the morning, you know, during the daylight. This, I don't know if they were on the level or not, but I know that they went to my next door neighbor on the right-hand side, they visited them, and then I spoke to my neighbor, and then they after they visited them, they went across the street on the David Brearley sidewalks on 14th Street. I forgot to put my address.
Yep.
34 North 14th Street.
Yeah, I see that.
Sorry.
And if you won't say your name, you didn't also state your name.
I'm sorry. I must be getting rusty. Joey Grimaldi. Well, anyhow, so I don't know if that was something shady or if that was just, but that's it. I just wanted to let everyone know.
Did you call the police?
No, we didn't. I guess I should have. And then after I came in, I didn't really go outside. I had my head outside the door and I spoke to them. After I let them go, I closed the door, and my mom promptly yelled at me, "What are you doing answering the door?" But, you know, it's just a natural reflex. But anyhow, that's it.
Thank you. Okay, does anyone else have anything to say for the good and welfare of Kenilworth?
I'll make it brief, Mayor. John Zimmerman, Kenilworth Police Chief. Just in response to Mr. Grimaldi, call the police department. We're service oriented. We'll come out, verify the people are who they say they are. Even though it may not maybe a reflex, as you said, a reaction. Could be somebody illegitimate going around at night. You're right, a lot of church groups do come around in the daytime. We can check them out and make sure that they're legitimate. Unfortunately, they don't have to register with us because the freedom of religion, so they can come out as long as they're a legit group. But if they're not, at the same time, we can find out what they're up to. And if not, we would take the necessary course of action to prevent them from harming anybody or stealing from anybody. And on another note, I know, Councilman Ladati brought up about the mayor coming out, and I just want to say thank you on Sunday. She met myself, my father, who's the president of the Seniors Club, on her own time, with her significant other, Joe Glow, and fixed the air conditioning unit in the vestibule that the seniors use. And in the, especially in the wintertime when it's cold, that's where they wait to get on and off the bus or for somebody to pick them up. And the DPW looked at the instruction manual I did, and it was definitely not that kind of issue. It was something that took more technical knowledge, and he climbed up onto the roof and took care of it in cold weather. And they both took a big chunk out of their Sunday, so I just want to say kudos to you both for doing a great job. And they didn't take any, and you know, the seniors were looking to reimburse them, and he refused to take any money. So thank you very much for the donation.
You're welcome.
And I know they're going to appreciate it. And they'll be able to have it cool in the summer and even winter, which is a big thing for seniors.
Of course, absolutely. Thank you very much. Thank you. Does anyone else have anything to add for the good and well-being of Kenilworth? Okay. Seeing no one, if there's nothing else for the public portion, can I have a motion to close the floor to the public?
So moved. Second.
Motion made by Councilman Grady, seconded by Councilman Clementi. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. Does anyone else have anything to say for the good and welfare of the borough?
Yeah, I just want to mention that we talked about that Raleigh River Watershed meeting that we attended last week, and it was pretty much a real eye-opener for me because I've never been to one of them before, but it's been going on for 30 years. It affects a large number of towns, including Kenilworth, and they're trying hard to get funding from the county, the state, the federal, Army Corps of Engineers was involved, but there's just a lot going on. It's very interesting to see, but it's important that they get something done because if we have another Sandy or Irene, we're in trouble for sure.
Absolutely.
So I'm going to continue to attend the meetings with the mayor and we can report back as the progress says what's going on.
Thank you.
Yes, I'd just like to say, you know, thank God for all volunteers 100 years, plus what's going on right now. This whole town should appreciate you guys and even say a little prayer for what's going on. Thank you again for your services. I think it's tremendous for us.
Absolutely. Thank you. Okay, does anyone else have anything to say? You want to add? Okay. If there's nothing else to be brought before the council, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second.
Now, motion made by Councilwoman Cecilia and seconded by Councilman Gotti. All in favor?
Aye.
Sorry.